Vicarage, Merton Cove, Middlewick. Mrs. Tube speaking. What name? I'm sorry, I didn't quite catch. I'm sorry, but could you speak a little more distinctly? You can't, but... Oh, it's Mrs. St. John Soames, but you don't sound like her somehow. You've dropped your what? That explains it. The vicar? No, he's not here at the moment, but I could take a message. Just one moment, I'll write it down. Hello? Yes. Mrs. St. John Soames has dropped and broken her upper set, so will be unable to take Sunday school tomorrow. Thank you, Mrs. St. John Soames. He'll find someone to take your place. You need not to worry. You've got enough on your plate. I mean, well, goodbye.
Light space and not a soul in the room.
Dad?
Damn and black.
Soon be in the bankruptcy court. Heaven knows I'm not a mean man, am I? What did you say?
Nothing.
Oh, and until recently I've always found my stipend to be, adequate. And I don't ask for the earth, I don't ask for wealth.
You know anyone to ask?
I'm happy in the knowledge that every penny that comes into this house does so by the sweat of my own brow.
Well, that's marvelous. You're happy and perspiring, so you're all right, Jack.
Jack?
Rather hoping we were off.
It's a housekeeping book.
What about it?
waited. It's a while since I last saw it, and I have enough now to spare, so...
You're a glutton for punishment. It's in the desk there. Help yourself.
Thank you, I will.
It's in the left-hand corner.
Penelope, what is this book doing in the vicarage?
The Bishop of Woolwich said it was all right.
This looks more like it.
Be careful, darling. Now keep the housekeeping money in it. There may be an odd 10-shilling note.
There is no 10-shilling note, Arthur, otherwise.
How's that, Em? Very pretty, Ida. I shall never walk again, but thank you.
November, December. I shall be at my dinner if I'm needed. This housekeeping book of yours should be fascinating reading.
It opened up a whole new world to the Bank of England.
You going out, Ida?
Yes, sir.
Are you seeing Willie Briggs?
That was the idea, sir.
You tell Willie that I am very displeased with him.
Oh, sir.
Very displeased. He failed to appear to choir practice last night.
Yes, sir. He meant to appear.
Magnanimous of him, but he didn't.
No, you see, he'd forgotten to post his...
His what?
That's right. And he had to go back to the farm. By the time he'd gone back and then to the post, well, there didn't seem much point, did there?
There doesn't seem much point in him being in the choir if he cannot attend his practices. You knew very well we were having an extra rehearsal for the carol service. I was not at all happy about it last year.
Nor was anybody else.
Oh, I was not aware that any of the congregation had complained.
All I'm saying, Lionel, is they didn't look happy, and you must admit that, on the whole, it was a bit of a shambles.
The carol service? A shambles?
Well, when you announce, God rest ye merry gentlemen, and the organ plays, there's no business like show business.
I will not stay here and listen to such nonsense. When you put the room straight, you can bring a cup of coffee to me in the dinner.
Yes, sir. I'll go and...
What are you doing? I said when you... Really, Penelope, that girl is quite impossible. It baffles me why we keep her.
It would baffle me still more to find anyone who could do half the work Ida does for twice the money.
I'm not saying she isn't a good worker.
You certainly aren't. Not in front of me. Ida is an absolute angel. She must be to put up with it. Us.
By us, I presume you mean me.
Well, you do rather impose on the girl, don't you?
I impose.
Just now, for instance. Bring a cup of coffee to me in the den.
Well, a perfectly simple request.
Why, this is Ida's night out. She was supposed to be gone half an hour ago.
Then why didn't she?
She's waiting for the Prince to call for her.
Waiting in the kitchen, I suppose.
Yes.
Burning my electric light.
Oh, really, darling?
The electricity bill I received yesterday.
Lionel, if you mention that damn electricity bill again, we had it for breakfast, lunch, and supper yesterday. Breakfast and lunch today.
And yet, I come into this room and I find 1, 2, 3, 4,
10!
10! 10 lamps burning.
All right. Holy moly, it's all my fault. I'm to blame, and I'm so sorry, and it won't happen again. And instead of buying me a Christmas present, why don't you use the money to pay for the electric light bill? And for heaven's sake, is there anything more I can do?
You can take a breath, for one thing. You must certainly stop acting a martyr. You know, perfectly well I wouldn't dream of not buying you a Christmas present. Though, if that girl does not change her ways, she will most likely get nothing from me this year.
After what you gave her last year, I don't think that will worry either.
I gave her...
I know, darling. A very lovely book. Pilgrim's Progress.
I also sent a 10-shilling postal order in between the pages.
Well, if you flipped it anywhere beyond page 3, she never got it.
Incidentally, have you put in your orders for the Christmas shops yet?
Not yet.
Before you do, I think it would be as well if I were to look them over.
Very well, Lionel.
And by the way, were you thinking of a turkey this year?
If I was, it would be very, by the way. No, I believe Mr. Duke makes some very excellent beef sausages, and we could run a bottle of catsup.
No, there's no need to be facetious. As a matter of fact, I would like you to get a turkey.
You would?
Yes, my dear.
But what about the electric light bill? Why buy a turkey and eat in the dark? And after all, it's only the two of us, I'm sure, a couple of day old.
I rather thought we might invite someone to spend Christmas Day with us.
Oh, who?
Someone who would otherwise spend it alone.
Just who is this someone?
Miss...
Not Miss Gillen.
Oh, precisely.
Why?
Penelope, I know exactly how you feel about Miss Gillen.
And you also know how she feels about me.
Exactly how I feel about her.
Yet you have the nerve to invite her over here for Christmas Day? That's interfering busybody, that's sex
stuff. Lonely is the word. Miss Gillen is one of the most ardent church workers to boot.
To boot? is wrong. She hates my guts.
Penelope.
And the way she looks at me just because I've been on the stage. Anyone would think I've been on the streets.
I'm sure you and Miss Skillet would understand each other so much better if you could only get that over.
Over a turkey? Not even a boiling fowl? Why, well, you haven't actually invited her, have you?
As a matter of fact, I have.
And she accepted.
Oh, she did.
Why? I'll never forgive you. Never.
Here we are, sir. Here's your coffee. Shall I take it up to the den?
No, thank you. Give it to me, please. I don't want the tray, thank you.
I haven't sugared it yet. How many?
Three, that's fine with you.
Haven't I got a sweet tooth, hasn't you?
Not as sweet as all that, so.
I'll tell it to me.
Thank you. What is this? Coffee? Or last night's dishwater?
Coffee? Well, it must be. We've got sugar in it. Let's see, not knowing the difference. You all right, huh?
I'm better in health than temper.
Where was that?
Won't it be Willie Briggs?
What? At the front door? You'll hear my tongue if it is.
Good evening. In 2 minutes' time, you will be hearing the second of four talks by Professor Zimmerman on the habits of the Himalayan anteater.
That's all I need.
Beezum.
Ida, I'm on the third program. How do I get off it?
You just needed him. Beezum, it's Miss Skillin.
What is?
It's Miss Skillin at the door.
What does she want?
But see, she's filled in with her bicycle lamp. She says it's gone out and won't come back on again. Perhaps she's run out of oil.
Foolish version, but what does she expect me to?
Oh, it isn't you, she wants them. Seems she's fiddle-diddled all she can, and she wonders if the vicar will come and fiddle-diddle with her. She's on the doorstep.
Push her off it.
Of course, we know it's all an excuse to see the vicar, don't we, Em?
We certainly do.
But say this for her, she never gives up.
Well, get rid of her, Ida, for goodness sakes.
Yes, Em, but how?
I don't care how. Tell her we're all in quarantine for distemper.
Yes, and wouldn't it be funny if we were? She's here. I hope you're not interested.
So sorry, Miss Skillin. Sorry, can't hear a word. Ida, come and help.
Is she a potion?
Chest off it. Within reason, of course.
You got something on your chest, Miss Skillin.
I have just left the Institute, Vicar. I happened to be passing, so thought I would look in.
How thoughtful. Were there many young people there?
At least 20 boys and girls.
Good. Good.
I doubt you would think so if I told you what they were doing.
So glad I stayed.
Penelope! What were they doing, Miss Skidden?
They were gambling.
What?
With my own eyes, I saw them.
Gambling in the Church Institute?
There was money on the table.
When I had expressly forbidden, when only last Sunday in my sermon I...
What were they playing, Miss Skidden? 21?
20.
One, you know.
No, Mrs. Chief, I do not know.
Well, someone holds the bank. He deals a card all around. The idea is to get 21, you see? You buy your other cards, of course, and the ace is either high or low, 11 or 1, whichever you wish, you see?
Penelope!
I used to watch the boys play sometimes when I was on tour. On train calls, they would indulge after they tired of mobile play.
I would not have you treat gambling with such levity. You know, I disapproved of the idiocy before.
Yes, Lionel?
I'm determined to do all of my power to stamp it out here. In this parish.
Well said, Vicar.
Thank you, Miss Skidden. When Adam Fellow was decreed henceforth, that man should earn by the sweat of his own brow and not make easy money by cards, horse racing, dog racing, nor even premium bonds.
What's the wrong with premium bonds?
They are a form of gambling, and as such I disapprove of them.
Well said, Vicar!
Oh, thank you, Miss Skidden. There are none in this house, nor will there ever be.
Oh, Lord!
I beg your pardon. Penelope, you haven't.
Afraid so, dear.
What?
Uncle's sending me half a dozen of them as a Christmas present. My Uncle Dudley, the Bishop of Wax.
The Bishop sending you premium bonds?
He is. Bless him.
I.
Well said, Vicar.
Miss Skidden, these gamblers in the Institute, did you remonstrate with them?
I tried to. It was not easy, really. Boys and girls today.
Did you tell them that you would inform me?
I most certainly did.
Oh, and what did they say to that?
I would rather not repeat it. Then, when I left the Institute, I found my bicycle lamp out and not come on again. I strongly suspect that the bull had been interfered with.
I shall go across to the Institute at once. These youngsters need to be taught a lesson. It is my duty to inform them that they can neither gamble in the Church Institute nor interfere with Miss Skillin's bulbs.
Either.
What are you? We cannot have you bursting into this room and it's unseemly. What do you want?
I want to go upstairs.
What?
Not for that. Excuse me. It's in my bedroom. I've got to get it. Willie says there's no use without it. Excuse me!
Penelope, I warn you, unless you exercise some control over that girl, she will have to go. Really, bursting into the room like that.
Darling, be fair. It's her night out. She's going out with her boyfriend.
That may be, but...
I used to be just as excited when I was going out with you.
There is no need to...
I've got it. Wouldn't it have been awful if I'd lost it? Excuse me, I've got to get back to Willie. Otherwise, we'll be running around the kitchen like a rampaging lion. You going out, sir? Thought you might be somehow. Kay said I'd see you again, Miss Skidden, and I'll say goodnight.
Penelope!
Darling, there are no stamps on her cards. Otherwise, she'd be gone first thing tomorrow morning.
I have to get across to the Institute. We will discuss that girl's future when I return.
If you return.
What?
Well, you know what youngsters are like these days. They're apt to get tough.
I am not incapable of getting tough.
Of course you aren't, darling. Now, where did I put your switchblade knife? Perhaps Miss Skillin could lend you her bicycle chain.
Miss Skillin, she mustn't pay any attention to Penelope. She has no sense of humor.
Of course not, Vicar, as if I would. All the same, I'm quite sure you have no trouble with Institute, no trouble at all. Just in case.
In case what, Miss Skidden?
Any of the young people can get out of hand. I was wondering whether perhaps one of us can get you, Vicar.
Oh, which one?
A woman's restraining influence, invaluable on such occasions.
Really? There's no need for either of you.
Well, I'm afraid it's out of the question as far as I'm concerned. My ankle?
Yes, Mrs. Chief, I thought that.
Really? This is quite unnecessary.
Of course you had, so it will have to be you, won't it?
Really, this is quite unnecessary. I can take care of myself.
Oh, haven't you gone yet?
Well, upon my word! Penelope!
Darling, stamps or no stamps, tomorrow at the crack of dawn.
Shall we go?
Oh, Miss Skidden, I can't let you.
What's the betting?
I insist, Vicar.
I...
Any case, Lionel, you'll have to run Miss Skidden home, won't you?
What?
You can't possibly let her cycle home in her condition.
In her...
Minus a bulb.
Minus a... Oh. I see what you mean. I may be allowed to drive you home.
Thank you, Major. I'm most grateful.
That settles it. Now, off we'll go across to the Institute.
There is no need to sound so sort of picnic going on.
Feeling it might be.
You're ready, Miss Kitten.
Quite ready. May I wish you a very good night, Mrs. Tube?
I don't see why not. Good night.
Penelope, really, you are the most...
I'm the most broad-minded wife in the world,
I must be. I'm going to be the most patient husband.
You're a darling, and I adore you.
What?
Adore you.
Oh, yes, sir. You don't think I don't adore you in spite of your...
Mine!
Penelope, I...
Give me a kiss.
But Miss Skillin's right there.
What, Miss Skillin?
Oh, Penelope! Oh!
Oh.
I was just saying, au revoir to Mara.
I'm so sorry, don't tell me, I can wait my turn.
No!
Don't forget, you did that deliberately.
I always kiss deliberately, darling, you know that.
You did not miss skidding. I. Oh, what's the use? I must go.
My hat.
The lights, will you put some of them out, please?
Yes, dear.
Bye bye, Nelly. No. No, 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 goodness gracious, no, not again!
Bye bye!
Is he really gone now?
Ida! You really shouldn't!
Oh, I know I shouldn't, aren't I awful? But no, I'm in such a state I can hardly control myself. Took me up the stairs!
Ida, pull yourself together!
I can't, you don't know what's happened. It's too wonderful, marvelous. You don't know. Happened, and when you do...
What has happened, for goodness sakes?
I can't tell you. Not yet. Not to assure them to use awful premises.
What?
The vicar and Miss Skillin. Oh, I thought they'd never sling their oaks.
Either.
I'll just see if they've gone now. I managed to live through this night. They've gone.
Then perhaps now you can tell me what...
No, not me. You've got to hear it from Winnie Briggs.
Why? What?
Will you come into the kitchen and...
No! I'm afraid I can't. Not with this ankle. You can bring Willie in here.
What? Willie can come in here? Do you mean that, Adam?
Why not?
Well, that'll just about make his day, won't it? Excuse me. Willie! Willie's here,
Where?
Just here, Em.
Bring him in.
Willie!
London? What are you talking about, London?
You said I was to hop along, correct?
I know I did, but either. This pool isn't a local one run in the village?
In the village, huh?
Good heavens! Don't tell me it's one of those commercial affairs! Oh, good heavens. Mr. Tube would be furious if he thought I dabbled in a local game, but if he knew I was mixed up in... Now look, Willie, Ida must have nothing to do with it.
Nothing to do with it?
Nothing! If it got around that the vicar's wife gambled in football pools, I thought it was just a local effort to raise money for the football team or the Boy Scouts. I had no idea. If we want something, as you seem to think, well, you must have my share.
But I'm...
Oh, no, don't thank me. You can have my winnings. Share them between you. We can go towards your Christmas present.
Christmas?
Christmas? But mine.
No, no, don't thank me. You don't know if we want anything yet. When will you know?
Tomorrow morning, Uncle Louie's seeing the results from the Sunday paper. He's only checked with the wireless so far, and them announcers do gabble, so...
Checked?
Yes, you see, Willie keeps a copy. Willie?
What?
Got the copy? you see, them's all the draws and wins and things, aren't they, Willie?
Are, and only 8 matches due today.
But, you see...
No, I'm afraid I don't see. It looks like, well, it could be the Hallelujah Chorus in Chinese for all my... You say if that's right, then you may have won something.
Listen.
Well, how much could it be, Willie?
Well, ma'am, last week for the same points as we've got, it was 280,000.
Could you imagine me saying to Mr. Tube, "Darling, I've won 86,866,000 pounds, 15 shillings and a penny. Could you ever forgive me?" Doesn't make sense, does it?
Something's wrong somewhere.
Figures, right? Spent all night working it out.
Fancy me, with all that money, be able to buy myself one of them nylon fur coats, won't I, eh?
Nylon fur? Darling, you'll be able to buy yourself a mink for every day of the week, and a diamond tiara to clean the car in. Can't believe it will happen. I wonder how soon you shall know.
Willie's calling in on his way to church, eh? Though, what good will the inquire, I'm not sure. With that excited, he won't be able to see you know.
That will be something. Do I have to send a telegram?
Yes, em. We want you to help him work it out.
Who to?
The poor people in London.
Are they going to like that?
But they get telegrams every week, em?
Right in the middle of their Sunday lunch. Speaking of Sunday lunch, that reminds me, we have a guest.
A guest, em?
Mr. Tooth can't possibly take the services in his condition, so Mr. Humphrey from St. John's Baptist is coming over. We shall have to feed the man and help him. I'll get started off upstairs, and then we'll get busy in the kitchen.
Yes, sir.
We're neither of us very good cooks, are we?
Never.
But what we shall do to the roast today, I shudder to think.
Oh, you buzzy.
Penelope!
time you've really gone too far, Ida. Penelope!
Mrs. Tooth knows about it.
Mrs. Tooth is also going to know that I know about it. Penelope! Oh, Mrs. Tooth, I should you for the last time, my girl. Penelope!
You calling, Lionel?
I am. Will you please come down here at once, please?
Just a minute, Lionel.
I said at once, Penelope.
Yes, dear, but...
And I meant at once. It's time I asserted my authority in this house.
Possibly, sir, but don't you think you ought to insert it sitting down?
Oh. Lionel, your leg, you know, you really shouldn't be.
Oh, you shouldn't be, yeah.
Penelope, I know.
What?
I found out.
Lionel, you haven't.
I most certainly have. Ida has confessed.
Oh, my goodness, Ida, how could you?
Oh, no, Mum, I did it, but I've never...
Not as lying to your other misdemeanors.
You don't really keep quiet, sir.
Ida!
I...
Did you say something I shouldn't find out?
Lionel, I can explain at least I can try.
No, I don't explain. Keep them guessing.
Be silent!
Not while there's breath in my body to utter. Mum.
Penelope, I'm determined that this creature shall cause no more trouble in this house.
Ida? But it wasn't Ida's fault.
What do you mean?
I grant you, Ida suggested it, and not that I blame her for that.
Ida suggested you do it. Stop scratching! Answer that.
Hello? Wrong number.
I must be going completely and utterly mad. Am I to understand that you should say that you should do what Ida said you did?
Yes, dear, I suggested it, and I didn't see any harm in it, really. I thought it might be fun, so I did.
And I believe my ears. You thought it might be fun to knock all the ornaments off a mantelpiece, so you did it!
Ornaments? Ornaments! Ornaments!
Unless you keep quiet, that will be my privilege. Penelope, I can only think you should be going completely mad.
Scrape!
Oh, will you think it's right? I have 10 shillings a week from now until the ornaments are paid for?
10 shillings a week?
I am inclined to make it 15.
15? Do be quiet.
I will certainly stop 2 and 6 a week from your wages, young woman.
Oh, sir.
2 and 6 a week from now until third Sunday after Epiphany.
Sir.
A word! Your community, the subject is closed.
Thank goodness.
I'm going back into the kitchen when Mr. Hungry arrives.
Had a good trip.
More like, you know, you really shouldn't be walking about. You go into the kitchen, got your books, candle, and things. You know, you'd be much safer in bed.
But Mrs. Gillen is coming to see me.
Then you'd be much safer out.
That was a near go, wasn't it? I thought you were going to let the cat out of the bag.
Don't talk about it, I'm still covered with goose pimples.
Where's my candy, my books, and my paper? I left them. I don't know where they were.
I thought we'd been through all of them. Ida, the front door.
Yes, sir. Wonder what fate holds in store for us now.
Penelope, it's no use. That girl will have to go. Had a good trip.
Yes, dear, after tea. What is it you...
My paper, my books, and my pens. I left them on the dining room table, and I...
Lionel?
What? They're not in there.
Lionel.
I considered it my duty.
So did the gamekeeper.
Please, it's, Florence Nightingale.
Who?
Treatment. Look what can they come with?
Septicemia!
think I'd rather cook with Thatch thing.
Now, we aren't going to be difficult, are we?
Of course we aren't, darling. I expect Mother... Miss Skillin knows best.
Thank you, Mrs. Tupin. Sure I do.
Penelope, please.
Nothing more to be said. Now, off both you go. I must see about lunch.
You will still be here at lunchtime, Miss Skillin. That depends on how we are getting along, won't it?
I see what you mean exactly.
Penelope.
I must say, Mrs. Tupin takes the condition very lightly. I'm not sure she realizes just how serious it is. That head, let me look at it.
Oh,
I don't like that.
Neither do I.
That leg.
Oh, no. Miss Skillin, really. The bishop would walk in.
Just like us, we're going to have to work on this.
Oh, no. No, no.
Look me in the eye, Mr. Two.
Can't not ever again.
Straight in the eye. Horrible.
Ghastly.
We look like having trouble.
I fear that, too. Oh, no.
We're not by any chance feeling light-headed. We're not. Confess?
I'm not.
What?
I'm not!
I should be surprised if this is what you flat on your back. On the right side, shall we? Up is the bed ready? Waiting. Good.
Wonderful.
Into bed we go. A great time will be had by all your
prejudices. Really, I must point out that it is quite right that after all you are one of my own parishioners and I...
I'm off to your desk, Mr. Two.
Yes, but what would the world think?
My uniform is my protection.
Yes, then I assure you, you will not need your uniform.
Friendship must be put aside. You are my patient. I'm your nurse. You must not think of me as a woman.
I never have. Here, I've got the paper.
Have we won?
I don't know. Mrs. Duke's got the coupon.
Have we won?
I don't know. You've got the coupon.
I haven't got it. He's got it.
You've got it.
I haven't got it.
Perhaps Mr. Toops has got it.
I'll go it. Don't be silly, Ida. Well, you must have it.
No one.
When did you last see your coupon?
I had it here, Mum, last night.
Then it must still be here.
Well, let's look for it.
It's Yorkshire pudding whatever you've done today. Ida, did you turn the room out this morning?
Yes, I'm in a manner of speaking.
And you didn't see anything of Willie's form?
No, Mum.
Then Willie, you must have it on you somewhere.
But I'm sure.
Wait, Grace, don't argue. Mrs. Tupin knows what she's talking about.
Have you been through all your pockets, Willie?
No, Mum, because...
Well, go through them now, Mum.
Ida, is that kind?
No, Mum, it wasn't meant to.
Stick these stones and break my bones.
We've no time for poetry. Off with it.
Oh, she'll have to marry me now.
You go through this, sir. Being married, you'll have more practice.
Ida, are you suggesting I... They usually make a little slit in the lining.
There. You didn't ought to go through them pockets, son. You don't know what you might...
Off with it.
Any striptease?
What?
I'm gay.
No! Believe
no!
Definitely not. Willie, what on earth? Heavens. Gumdrops?
Ah, they're for church. You can have one if you like.
Look as if they've been had one already.
All he thinks about is his stomach, eh?
That's what you think? Continental art studies, Willie!
Ah, it's for the sermon.
She must be deformed.
Oh, let me see that. Being on a farm, that's what does it to him. Being raised among all them animals. Get rid of that, and go through your trousers.
Well, there's nothing Willie's form in here.
I could have told you that, Mum, but you would not listen. It ain't likely it would be.
Why not?
Because I weren't wearing this suit last night.
Willie! Oh, well, let's look for it, for heaven's sake. There's 260,000 pounds at stake.
You too.
Good morning.
Willie, you
Aston Villa. Birmingham. Oh, of course, need you to check. On your knees already? We've got the Church Times. Couldn't be better, could it?
That doesn't give me a...
I've already read it.
Okay, well, if you don't tell Mrs. Tip I lent it to you, I could give you last week's copy of War Cry.
You don't happen to have a copy of, say, the News of the World?
Mr. Humphrey, aren't you the one?
Please, you understand, I...
Of course you did. You're human, aren't you? Without human passions.
Oh, what?
Tell you what, Willie Briggs, that's my boyfriend. He's in the choir. He gets it.
How gratifying.
Isn't it? He reads it in the sermon and says it helps pass the time. Well, he can pass it to you during one of the hymns if you like, and you can pass it back.
Well, really.
The congregation won't notice. They're blind as bats anyway, all three of them.
Anyone got it?
No.
Well, it's not in the kitchen, so it must be in here. We'll just have to turn everything in this room upside down. Would you like to go upstairs?
Why?
You must want to wash before you take the service. You know where the bathroom is, second on the left.
Thank you for advising me.
Oh, I do. You'll find it's a very long service. The choir is terribly slow in the songs and hymns.
I see what you mean. You did say you said it before, but...
Yes, not the first. My husband and Miss Gillen are in there.
Choir.
Now we can get on with it. Ida, do you smell burning?
Yes, ma'am.
Me?
The roast is on my gas. Should be on low.
Now we've lost the roast, too. Willie Briggs, don't sit there like a stuffed dummy. Get up. Put your waistcoat on again. And your jacket. Other way.
And Mrs. Tip probably didn't mind about my scream. Probably sleep that way.
Oh, I don't know what's come over you, Willie. The thought of all this money is doing it to you.
Ah, proper sharp, aren't I? It ain't like me.
But we haven't even got it yet. Do help me look for that form, will you? Wait, what? Willie?
Oh.
Is this it? This is it, isn't it?
That's it, all right.
Oh, Willie! Aren't I wonderful? Oh!
Oh!
Willie! Oh.
Take me away!
My very dear,
yes, sir. My very dear Humphrey! That woman, she sucked up my trousers. You don't know what she wants to do to me. She wants
to... No, don't.
She wants to put my leg in splints.
Oh, but Mr. Tibbs.
I must hide. I must get out of her clutches.
Hide?
You don't know, Mr. Humphrey. She means well, but where can I go?
Where would you like to go?
Mr. Humphrey, help me! Help me!
Of course, but what?
The potting shed.
Potting.
Take me to the potting shed. You will think to look for me there. Please, Mr. Humphrey, the potting shed.
But you're not dressed for the potting shed.
There must be something I can wear there.
Where?
Come on, Red. Hurry, Miss Gillen will be back in the bedroom at any minute, and...
Mr. Toot! Ah!
I'm going to to do, 5 people to feed him.
Your husband has disappeared.
4 people to feed him.
Mrs. Tube, will you listen to me? I'm trying to tell you.
Miss Gillen, without wishing to be antisocial, the only thing I wish you would tell me is that you aren't going to be here for lunch.
Of course, how is it the two people are mad? I'll tell you again, Mrs. Tube. Your husband has disappeared from his bedroom. He's in a dangerous condition.
Ida, you think your mother could put us a tin of corned beef?
Corned beef? Mrs. Tube?
I could get him dried out, couldn't I?
Miss Gillen, you and Ida, your bicycle?
That girl touching my bicycle off.
You'll have to walk, Ida, but remember, we went for lunch, not supper.
I'm going to search every room in this house, Mrs. Tube. And if I can't find the vicar, I shall organize a search party!
Do, do, but for heaven's sake, don't bring them here for me.
Now I can at least be able to
attempt to think.
No, don't forget not to have shown you it. Willie! We found him!
What?
The copy! Now we can see if we've won all that money.
I'd give my share to anyone who produced 2 pounds of rump steak.
Got your newspaper to check with. Then what are we waiting for?
Church!
There's a shrubbery around it. That'd be your next objective. If Mr. Chu is not there, you report back here to me. I, in the meantime, will arrange to bivouac.
Oh. Oh! Willie, thank goodness you're. Will you be an angel and go after Ida and ask her?
Briggs is already fully occupied, Mrs. Chu.
But this is important, Miss Kaelin. Ask Ida if she.
And the fact that your husband is missing is not important.
Not in the least. So long as he stays that way.
Not important!
Ask Ida if she can get 2 tins of corned beef. Tell her we have a guest for lunch.
Mrs. Chu? This is too much!
Much too much!
You have deliberately brought me up my right-hand hand!
Well, for heaven's sake, you can't use your left, can you?
I...
And Mrs. Gillen, I must ask if you can all work paraphernalia out of here. Camera, I'm having a guest for lunch. I can't have the place looking like Epsom after Derby Day.
I need headquarters to work from. This search for your husband may take hours.
The potting ships at your disposal.
You haven't had the last of this. Such callousness.
And if you find it cold, there's a stove under the bench. Don't be silly, Lionel. It's me.
I thought you were Miss Gillen. She locked up the wardrobe and taken the key.
Lionel! So that's what you're up to. You're leaving me.
Leaving me?
You're joining the Gordon Highlanders, darling. You mustn't. You haven't got the right kind of knees.
This is no time for horseplay.
What? I want to see if it's true what they say about kilts.
Where is Miss Gillen?
She's in the potting shed.
Are you sure?
Positive.
I find it very chilly in that coat.
I think we can do that. Perhaps some coffee?
I think I need something a little stronger than coffee.
Lionel!
You know the doctor said about my blood pressure? It's low.
I'll pour you a glass of elderberry wine. That'll push it up. I was saving it for Christmas. Pour all over Miss Gillen and set her alight.
When I cook in the cupboard of my own home.
Put your lights up. Ooh, not too far up. Bottoms up.
Penelope, this isn't a cocktail party. This is just what the doctor ordered.
I know. I made it.
Humphrey in church?
Yes.
I hope he isn't the only one.
Darling, you mustn't worry. I know business is bad.
Business? Penelope, really?
But it might pick up. We must hold our heads high and cling to our faith in the pole. Heaven.
I wish heaven would send me some trousers. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that.
Lionel, suppose heaven were to grant you every one of your wishes and me every one of mine. I mean, suppose heaven paid for the electric light building, all the other bills, and a new coat of paint all over the vicarage, and let me see, what else?
Some new bells for my church.
Dozens of them, all shapes and sizes, and new hassocks so that people can pray without breaking their kneecaps, an oven that does its own cooking, bottle of fridge perfume, my sin, economy size, a washing machine, and something I've always wanted.
What's that?
A make bedspray.
I say, steady.
A new car for you with safety belts, and oh, I just don't know. Lionel, suppose heaven sent you all those things, what would you say?
Say? Thank you very much.
Would you take them?
Take them, of course I'd take them.
Lionel!
If heaven sent them.
But heaven sometimes appears in strange forms. Look at manna.
Manna?
From heaven? It fell all over the Israelites and they all got turned into pillars of salt.
Penelope, there are certain inaccuracies in your biblical observations.
All I'm saying is, you never know which way heaven is going to jump.
Jump?
You didn't know Miss Gillen was going to put you to bed, did you?
That was not heaven, that was—
Lionel! Now all of a sudden, Uncle is coming on to lunch.
The bishop?
You mustn't see me like this. Penelope, you must buy me some trousers.
Well, you're not having mine.
That's another thing, Penelope. You know how I disapprove of you wearing garments normally worn by the members of the opposite sex. I wish you'd take them off.
Well, all right.
What? No, no, you mustn't do it.
Empty houses, Mr. Humphrey. I know, I've played Oldham. And might I say, how very nice you look.
Nice?
Your hat is in surplus. So nice.
How nice.
And however do you? It's amazing.
What is?
Your surplus. It's white, and not just white.
sorry about the house. Church. How are attendants is at bad, Pastor?
Sometimes I outnumber them there too.
I suppose the answer lies with us then, Humphrey. Are we lacking something today? Oh. I wonder if there's a spare pair in the attic. I'll go rummage around if you'll forgive me. Help yourself to a book if you care to. Something rather distinguished about wearing a kilt. I wouldn't mind the privilege of wearing the tartan myself. I wonder if there's a clan McAtoo.
Mend it. I've got to take this to Mrs. Tube. She's very worried. There isn't very much of it, is there? But it's all Mother had. Okay, Mr. Humphrey, to help Mrs. Tube out at lunch, when she offers you any corned beef, will you just say, no thank you, I'm not hungry?
Shiny white beef? They're mad. Insane. They should be put away. All of them.
No Wolves, Chelsea Sheffield Wednesday, Luton Liverpool, Cardiff Preston North End.
Mr. Humphrey, are you all right?
Mr. Tube, such news, such wonderful news. Oh, happy Humphrey. I watch you dance, I watch you sing. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small.
Mr. Humphrey, have you been drinking?
No, not yet.
Mr. Humphrey!
Mr. Tube, I think it's happened.
What has?
My trouble, Chance. I think it's come up.
Should we wear a belt or something?
No, my pool.
Your what?
Pool, football, you know.
Oh, God!
Oh, Mr. Tube, I'm so sorry. I got carried away. Did it hurt?
Yes.
Let me assist you.
Assist me? Don't you dare to talk to me, you damn fool.
Oh, Mr. Tube.
Mr. Humphrey, shame on you, shame on you. Can I believe my...
Is. Oh, what your master said is about
to be the That's you. That is your agent in your clutched gamble in the pool. Oh, Humphrey!
Too big.
You shall leave my house.
Oh.
Take it with you, your ill-gotten gains.
But I haven't got them yet.
Leaving me secure that I will not share your same cravings for wealth. But I am content with my own little lot.
But I haven't even got a little lot. Mr. Tube, do let me explain how little you know, Arthur.
I intend to know them even less. Oh!
Not one penny of what I haven't yet got will go into my own pocket.
Ha! I did not.
I'll be with you in a minute. I seem to have lost my feet. There. Mr. Tube, have you ever been troubled by the Death Washington?
I can't say that I have.
It's all over the roof of my church, bleeding in.
What?
I must stop the bleeding.
What?
Derek Service and others of class will send my congregation in. Get in there.
Get in mine.
When Polly dead, pray for Sergeant Kevin in case the ceiling comes down and they get it.
You must do something about it. You must take steps.
I did. I started with mine. In 3 months, all I got was two shilling pieces, and one of those is back.
Huh. That rings a bell. Or rather, it doesn't.
What does?
Have you ever been troubled by bells?
Bells.
I want new bells in my church. I started a fund. I told my congregation, stop at nothing. And they did.
Then we're in the same boat. Now, here comes my point, Mr. Church. Hearing a fortune was one of the fools I began to dabble.
Dabble?
And I dabbled and dabbled. Can you blame me, Mr.
Church? You mean you dabbled not for yourself, but for your beetles?
Yes, there's no harm in that, is there?
I suppose not.
John, now if my forecast is correct, I have succeeded beyond my wildest dreams. I hope I shall have enough here to spare.
To spare?
For other worthy causes.
My bells! Mr. Humphrey, accept your offer.
Have I made any offer? Oh, I see a taken.
Do you mind?
Not at all.
Not one penny for your own use.
No, of course not, though I half thought that perhaps a motor scooter would be nice.
A motor scooter?
Do you travel carriage?
And there's just scooters around the... Yes, why not? Now, what do you mean if your forecast is correct? Don't you know?
Oh, well, of course I, checked once. And, my reading glasses are left in the
bedroom. You must check again.
We.
Indeed, how do we do it?
The paper, the news of the world.
Archdeacon tells all? Oh, surely not.
My form. Oh, my goodness, where did I...
What does it look like?
Who has done this?
Mr. Humphrey, Miss Skinner! Miss Skinner!
I took the phone to check!
Get it! Penelope, is that you?
Uncle!
Penelope?
Darling, do you like corned beef?
I love it.
Oh. Oh, well. Why didn't anyone tell me you were here?
I don't think anyone cared. I rang the bell.
That
always work.
But the front door was open, so I came in.
How wise of you.
I wonder.
Uncle, that's that. What happened to your nice talker?
The dean said on it last week, and I can't afford another.
Oh, I see. Well, come and have a seat.
Thank you.
You must excuse me if I seem a little distraught.
Please, Grace, please,
What is it, Ida?
Will you come and see William?
Oh, Willie, but I can't just now, not with.
Please, he's in a terrible state.
Why, what?
He says that, your Grace, this isn't for your ears. His pools don't come up, he's going to.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes.
Oh, Ida, where is Willie?
He's in the kitchen. If he isn't in the pond by now.
I'll come right away.
Thank you, your Grace.
Uncle, you must excuse me for a moment if I, Oh! That nice, darling. He wishes me a Merry Christmas.
My dear Penelope.
No.
Everton, Paul.
Willie! Willie! You mustn't do it, Willie! Your Grace, tell him you mustn't do it!
You mustn't do it, my boy!
You see, the bishop of the Church of White Foundation says you mustn't do it!
But I...
I caught him,
Goodness, Willie, you had a scare!
But I saw him walking into oblivion,
I was walking to the vestry.
What?
Oh, to get one of these.
And after I told Mrs. Two, I'm sure you were going to do away with yourself. Wait, Briggs, I'll never forgive you.
And I'll never forgive you either, scaring us all like that.
And I'll never forgive you neither, raising our hopes the way you did.
A cup of tea, Uncle?
No, thank you.
Make it out we'd won all that money when we had it.
Coffee?
You should have made certain before you ever said anything, shouldn't you, Apple?
We thought lunch about, one.
I think your cooperation is required.
What? Ida, what is it you...
I'm saying Willie should have made certain before he'd ever said
it. I was certain, practically. I could have swore they were right.
Well, you say it's right. How can it be wrong? Is it wrong? Then it can't be right, can it? Even you can see that, can't you, Your Grace?
Uncle, it is wonderful seeing you. But, of course, if only I'd known a little earlier, I...
No!
You were saying?
I've forgotten somehow.
Let me!
Don't do that! The bishop's nerves can't stand it!
It is right.
What?
My pools. It's right, I tell you.
But really?
If it isn't, then I'm going up the wall.
No, you're not. These walls have just been cleaned out.
Mrs. Tuke, look, I'm sure. Come and look, Mrs. Tuke.
Excuse me?
I don't understand it, Mum. One day it's wrong and the next it's...
Don't say it's right until you're certain.
Look, Mum, will you help check with me?
But, Willie, I don't understand it. It's all Greek to me.
Well, all you have to do, see, is...
No, I'm afraid I don't see. Sorry to be so stupid.
Dear. Oh, please, ma'am. Dear Grace, you're used to reading. Would you?
No, Willie, I can't ask the bishop to.
Why not?
After all, Uncle is a bishop.
Yes, but I'm sure he's not as black as he's... You will, won't you? Just to please Ida.
What's exactly?
No, he's going to do it, I knew he would. You are wonderful, aren't you?
Thank you. But would you mind telling me exactly what I...
Yes, first, you sit there, if it's all the same to you. There now, you just relax if you want. And Will, you sit there, next to his Grace. There, that's you two settled. I'll sit here. Okay, what about you, Will?
I'm all right here.
That's settled then. We ought to have our photos took.
Shall we?
No. There isn't any time. Besides, we haven't got a camera.
You ever had a parrot?
Never.
That's what I'm going to have if this comes up.
Really?
Ah, oh, they swear, you know.
So I'm told.
My auntie has one. I called her an old cow the other day.
Willie, why don't you explain to Uncle just what exactly we wish she would do?
Well, go on.
Excuse me. Well, it's to do with football, see?
Football?
You heard of it.
A fine manly game. You should play it, my boy. Do you good?
I do play it.
You do? Then perhaps you should give up.
I play in goal when it's dry.
And when it's wet?
And I let Mr. Tuke play instead.
Oh, good heavens.
I'm not daft.
I see you're not. He is.
He isn't very good.
Really?
He looks all right. You ought to see him.
I sure like to see him. Very much.
He isn't playing today.
Not football, he isn't. I shall have a word with him when he has finished his devotions. What exactly?
Well, you see the names there? And the figures after them? Well, the names of the teams, see?
I see.
And the figures of the scores, see? Well, I'm going to read off the names, and I want you to read off the figures after them. Think you can manage?
I shall do my best.
That's what I like to see. A willing horse.
Right then. Ready? Arsenal Wolves.
Arsenal Wolves. Wolves?
Oh, no, they're not really wolves.
No.
No, the Wolverhampton Wanderers. Wolves is just short, see?
I think so. These wolves are not wolves, just wanderers from Wolverhampton.
Well, what's the result?
I should say, offhand, a very lucky escape.
I mean the figures.
Ah, yes, the figures. Arsenal 2, Wolves 2.
Yes!
Yes!
Yes! Have we won?
You see, I knew they were right.
You are clever, aren't you, Your Grace? But then, of course, you're educated.
I'm glad I was able to oblige.
Oh, half a minute, Sean. Your Highness, we're not finished yet.
Not?
Oh, not by a long shot. You sit back down again.
But I want to have a word with Mr. Two.
Well, we have 7 results left.
7?
And we want them all to be draws.
Draws?
And you get 3 points for a draw.
I'll accept your word for it.
8 threes is 24, isn't it?
8 twos are 16. 8 threes are quite correct.
Oh, and 24 is the highest number of points we can get. And that's what I think we've got. Now, where were we? Chelsea, Sheffield Wednesday.
Chelsea 4, Sheffield Wednesday 4.
Yes, yes. That's another one right, Mrs. Two.
Oh, isn't he the cat's whiskers,
You're the cat's whiskers, Uncle, but don't lose your head.
You appear to have lost your husband.
Now, Luton, Liverpool.
Luton, Liverpool. Luton, O.
Oh, no, not O. Ought, vanille.
Luton, ought, not. Liverpool, not.
Yes!
1, 2, 3. You feeling all right?
Quite, thank you. And you?
Ah, proper. Cardiff, Preston, North End.
Cardiff 1, Preston, North End 1.
Yes, yes!
No!
No! I didn't say anything.
Shall we press on?
Brighton and Hove Albion and Norwich.
Norwich, charming city, and the cathedral indescribably beautiful.
Get on, Uncle!
Ah, yes, sorry. Where were we? Barnum Regis. What did you say?
Brighton and Hove Albion.
Oh, the Albion of Brighton. A lovely hotel.
Never mind the Albion Hotel.
I beg your pardon. Brighton and Hove Albion 2, Norwich 2.
Yes! 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 How many more are there, Willie?
3 of them.
Isn't it exciting? Sorry.
Not at all.
You should have said.
Next,
please. Southampton, Scunthorpe.
Scunthorpe, Southampton 1, Scunthorpe 1.
Three cheers for Scunthorpe, Pippin!
Heart of Midlothian Celtic.
Ah, Bonnie Scott.
Who, the Campbells are coming! Sorry.
Heart of Midlothian 4, Celtic 4.
Yes, yes!
Now the last one.
The last one. Oh, Captain Eric, can you?
I shall make an attempt.
Hibernian Motherwell.
Hibernian Motherwell.
Oh, look! You don't want me to scream, do you?
I really didn't. Hibernian not. Motherwell.
Now, Mrs. Troop, I wonder what you'll have to say. A man stark naked has been seen running over the middle with more. What?
Details given, I have reason to believe that man is Mr. Troop.
I shall not ask what those details are.
Come on, sir.
Here, let me see it.
It's no time to read newspapers. Mrs. Troop, didn't you hear me say the man is running about stark naked?
Well, if that's the way he likes to run about.
Mrs. Troop, are you going to feel like your husband altogether? I insist that you take a car and identify.
Miss Gillen, I draw the line between start naked and playing hide and go seek with naked metal run off more.
Very well, I shall go myself. I have no home.
I'll bet you haven't. Brace.
Sir.
You can drive, can't you?
Yes, but we.
You'll get the biggest car out of the garage and drive me in the middle with more.
But Miss Gillen.
No time must be lost. There's an east wind blowing. Now, Mrs. Gillen, you could get something to drape over your husband.
Miss Gillen, if you only.
Very well, I shall help myself.
Is it too wide to stop naked on middle and more?
Penelope, I. She's gone mad.
Michael, so that's where she works. Oh, and Mr. Humphrey, you know, we miss you.
We miss you.
What were you doing in that cupboard,
Mrs. Two?
Oh, Mr. Humphrey, you don't have to explain anything to me. After all, boys will be boys. Just, what were you up to?
Penelope,
what have you got there?
my new bells!
Oh, so that's why! You want a Sasquatch Beetle and a scooter! And you want a few church bells?
What about my bicycle?
Well, darlings, there's just a chance that... the front door! Don't you worry, Uncle, I'll get it!
Go on, sir. Read it. Read it.
The Dean of St. Paul's addressing the anti-gambling.
No, no, not that one. This one. We have 7 results right.
And there's only one more to read.
The bishop doing fools? Can I believe my ears?
Can I believe my eyes?
Go on, sir. Hibernian Motherwell.
Hibernian 2, Motherwell 2.
We won!
Come on!
What is it?
He's on the doorstep.
I'll remove him at once. Who is it?
His car's broken down in the village.
Whose house?
He wants some lunch!
Who does? The man from the Bulls?
No! The Archbishop of Canterbury!
Oh,